This is not a normal RetroPie setup. And what do I mean by that? Well, there's a hard drive, there's a Raspberry Pi, but the only difference is there's no SD card. Stick around to see how you can do it too. You know what time it is. Okay, so this project here is something that I've been working on for a while, and from what I can see, it hasn't actually been done before with RetroPie, so this is a first. What I wanted to do was to create a system that would boot off a hard drive without the need for an SD card. But I thought, well, RetroPie is a great contender for that because ROMs are so big and so forth, and needing the room on the hard drive itself will reduce the risk of losing your SD card because of all the writes that it's making. So what I'll do now is I'll go through and I'll show you how I actually set this up so you can do it too. So let's pop over to the Raspberry Pi and let's check this out. So now we're over on the Pi, an important thing to realize is that this will not work with all USB devices. I tried it on several hard drives and several USB sticks and some of them just didn't work. So it did take a little bit of trial and error to find one that did work. So you'll need to be patient with that. This also only works with the Raspberry Pi 3, and if you're using a USB 2.5 inch or a portable hard drive, you will need another power source for it because the Raspberry Pi 3 isn't powerful enough to power the USB hard drive. What you'll need is called a Y cable, and you can get those on eBay or Amazon. I've got some links down in the description below. So the first thing you're going to want to do is get into the command line, and to do that in RetroPie, you just need to hit F4 on the keyboard. Now, I will leave the command lines down in the description below, but what you need to type in is sudo apt-get update, 2 ampersands, and then sudo apt-get install, and then rpi-update. Press enter and be prepared to wait for a while. So I'll speed this up so that way you don't have to sit around and watch it, but go make a coffee and come back to it soon. Actually, I lied, it only took about a minute. So what you'll need to type in now is sudo branch in capitals equals next, and then rpi-update. What this command will do, it will download the latest boot files that will allow you to boot your Raspberry Pi from a USB device without the need for a micro SD card. This will only take about 2 minutes to finish. So once that's done, you'll be back to the command line again. So the next thing that we have to do is we need to put some information into the boot config file. So to do that, we'll type in echo program underscore USB underscore boot underscore mode equals 1. Then we'll use the line, which is above the enter key, and then sudo t-a /boot/config.txt. Now what we need to do is type in sudo reboot, and we'll reboot the Raspberry Pi, and we'll be back in a second. Once that's finished rebooting, we'll need to go back into the command line, so press F4 on the keyboard. And the first command that we'll need to type in is to figure out whether or not what we've done has worked. So we need to type in vcgencmd, then OTP underscore dump, then the line above the enter key, and then grep, and then 17, colon. Press enter, and when it comes back, it should come back if it worked correctly with 17, colon, 302.0.0.0.0a. If it did, then the next thing that we need to do is go into the config file. So to do that, we type in sudo nano /boot/config.txt. Now this will open up the editor, so we've just got to go right down to the very bottom with the arrow keys, and then we're just going to remove that program USB command line. After we're done, press Control X, Y, and then enter, and that will save the file. So now with the hard drive plugged in, what we'll do is we will start setting up the partitions. So to do that, we'll type in sudo parted /dev/sda. And the command that we'll type in now is mktable msdos. We just need to say yes here to destroying the disk label that's already on SDA. So the next thing that we're going to do is create the FAT32 partition for this hard drive. So to do that, we type in mkpart primary FAT32 0% 100M capital and press enter. And the next step is to create the Linux partition. So to do that, we type in mkpart primary ext4 100 capital M and then 100% and press enter. So what that's done now is it's created a 100 meg partition for FAT32, which is the boot partition, and then it's created the rest of the space as a Linux partition. And by typing in print, you can see the partitions and what sizes they are. So once you're done with that, all you need to type in is quit to exit the partition tool. Okay, so the next step is we're going to type in sudo mkfs.vfat, then dash n for Nelly, and then boot in capital, and then dash f capital, then 32, then /dev/sda1. Once that's finished, we'll do the same for the Linux partition, except a little bit different. We'll just type in sudo mkfs.ext4 and then /dev/sda2. This will take a little while, but once it's finished, we'll be back to the command line again. So now that we've set up the two partitions, what we'll do now is we'll start setting up copying across all the files from our RetroPie installation. So the first thing we'll need to do is type in sudo mkdir, then /mnt/target, press enter. And the next thing is to type in sudo mount /dev/sda2/mount/target. So what that's doing is creating a mount point for the Linux partition. So the next thing we need to type in is sudo mkdir /mount/target/boot and press enter. And then we'll type in sudo mount /dev/sda1/mnt/target/boot. And what that will do is it will mount the boot partition of the hard drive to that folder. Now the next step is to just do a quick update and make sure we've got rsync installed. So to do that, we'll type in sudo apt-get update, then 2 ampersands, and then sudo apt-get install rsync and press enter. And with any luck, this should only take about a minute. So once that's done, we'll type in sudo rsync -ax, then --progress, then a slash on its own, then /boot, then /mnt/target. And press enter and be prepared to wait a long time for this one to finish, because basically what it's doing is copying every single file from your RetroPie installation SD card and putting it onto your hard drive. And depending on how many ROMs and how many files, etc., you've got on there, is going to depend on how long it takes. It could be 10 minutes, it could be an hour, it could be 2 hours. So definitely go and relax and then come back and check on it every now and then. Okay, so now that we're back, what we'll do is we'll go into one of the mount directories. So to do that, we'll type in cd and then /mnt, then /target. And what we're going to do here is we're going to bind some system directories. So we'll do sudo mount --bind and then /dev/dev. Hit enter. Okay, and we'll do the same again, sudo mount --bind, then /sys, and then /sys, and hit enter. And then again, sudo mount --bind, then /proc, and then /proc, and press enter. So now what we're going to do is we're going to remove the SSH keys, so that way it's a little bit more secure. So to do that, we type in sudo chroot, then /mnt/target. Now, once we've got root access, what we'll do is we'll type in rm and then /etc/ssh /ssh_host and then the star symbol. Press enter. And now we'll hit in the reconfigure option. So to do that, we'll type in dpkg-reconfigure space openssh-server. This will only take a moment and that will reset the SSH keys. Once that is done, all we need to do is type in exit and we will be out of root access. And now we just need to unmount the bindings that we just did. So we'll type in sudo umount dev, enter, and then we'll type in sudo umount sys and enter. And then lastly, sudo umount proc and enter. Now the next commands I'm not even going to attempt to say because they're very long. So what I'll do is I'll put it on the screen now for you just so you can copy it down. Again, these will be in the description below. But what this is basically doing is adding some information to the command line portion of the boot file and also the FS tab. So once you've put these in, you'll need to press CD, the tilde key, which is above the tab on US keyboards. And once that's done, you need to type in sudo umount /mnt/target/boot, enter. This will unmount the boot partition. And then the next step is sudo umount /mnt/target. And finally, what we'll do is we'll power this off so we can take out the SD card. And to do that, we'll just type in sudo power off and press enter. So what you'll need to do now is you'll need to remove the SD card from your Raspberry Pi after it's powered off and just leave the USB stick or hard drive connected, and then we will start it up. And with any luck, and I do mean luck, it will start up like this right now. Now with my particular configuration, it does seem to take a lot longer to boot from the hard drive, but again, it could just be how I've set it up and the hard drive that I'm using. So after a lot of trial and error, I've finally got my RetroPie installation on my Raspberry Pi 3 to boot directly from my USB hard drive. Awesome. Okay, so as you can see, that's all set up, it's all running and it's all working. However, there are a few things that you need to know. One of them is that you need a special USB cable. And you can see from what I'm showing you now, it's a Y cable, so it actually transmits data as well as power through the one cable, normally. But this one, being a Y cable, sends the data down one end and then the power out the other end. Now the reason why this is needed, especially for a portable hard drive, is because of the power requirements of the portable hard drive to boot. Connected to a Raspberry Pi 3, it just won't work. So the link for this cable is down in the description below. Now, one of the other things with the cable and powering it is that you do need a power supply with a lot of power. Now, I actually fiddled around with this for quite some time and it took about 5 goes just for this video to get it to work properly. So it is something that you're going to have to play around with, and it doesn't work with all hard drives like I mentioned. Well, that's it for another video. I really hope you liked it. If you're not a subscriber already, make sure you do. And if you are, make sure you hit that bell icon so you get notified of my new videos. Share this video with a friend if you think they'd like it, and make sure you like and comment on this video too. And as always, imagine, learn, create.